All right, guys, this is pretty much a hands-on exercise. I'll show you how to move around brand logos on a positioning map. This is pretty much what you have to develop for your assignment. This has been one of the hardest things to teach in marketing forever. 3 years ago, it was the final exam question. Came up with this basic exercise in previous Mark 101 classes ago, is that it, Elias? So I'm going to walk you through it. I'm also going to give you this as a tutorial exercise next week. So guys, bear with me and let's see how we go. Now, the first thing I want to remind you of, our friend Sun Tzu, you win your battle by making no mistakes. In our business, it's understanding our competitors, what they offer, why customers buy what we do, why customers buy from us, and then using the marketing mix, communications, to influence, persuade, entertain, build a relationship to get people to buy our product or service. Now, I think we all get this. Marketing is about people and their needs. We're all varied. I think we figured that out already. Now, to me, the heart of marketing is segmentation, positioning, targeting your customers. The positioning exercise is what we're going to look at now. And guys, this is really it. We're positioning an attitude, belief, or a judgment in your mind. I say Rivers, and people go, that's an old man loser brand. You say Nike, people react. Gucci, when I showed you a picture of a Gucci wallet, was like, oh, that's wonderful. The Louis Vuitton belt, the VB. Most of us already have an attitude or a judgment. Rolex, Longines, Ferrari, BMW, you guys are the most opinionated when it comes to brands of any generation. So this little capture in here is what we as marketers are saying, we want you to think this. Rolex is for winners. Nike is for winners. Rivers is for middle-aged men who no one cares what they look like. Again, it's up to you. Now, this was always my favorite model. If I was ever doing a marketing mini report plan or what have you, this is it. It's exactly the same as Elliot, except it just, I like it. It's out of Kotler's textbook, the same process. You know, what are the positioning concepts is what we're going to look at now. The marketing of that is your MarCom subjects further on. What I want you to do now is just have a look at this little definition. Yeah, what is positioning? It's developing a marketing strategy and influencing how a particular market segment perceives a product. What is it? Right, Harvard University, Cambridge, Oxford, they're viewed as number one. They've done a lot of their marketing to just reinforce we're the world's best universities. Now, what's interesting and most critical is this section here. Marketers must understand the criteria a target consumer uses to evaluate competing products or services. And then we convince the customer that the company's product will meet those needs. You do a degree at UOW, you will get a job. You do a good degree at Wollongong Uni, you will get a good job. That I know, right? So again, this is where we come in. Our profession, we spend a lot of money on promotion, telling people what they should think of our brand and get it to lead to sales. This is the art of marketing. We're telling the story of our brand and how it's needed in your life. Yeah, having that diamond ring, the Michael Hill ring, or the Tiffany, a present from Tiffany's will make you far more fulfilled. Using particular makeup brands. All of this is our profession. I can't explain to you how critical it is you read this chapter and go through this in detail, because everything we do relates to us trying to fill those boxes in with a positive brand image. Now, how do we do it? Again, I think you get it. It's positioning. How do we influence consumers relative to the perception? It's the choice map. Now, its objective, ideally in positioning, is to occupy a clear, unique, and advantageous position. In other words, where they, under the right conditions, we'll make them an offer they can't refuse and they'll buy our product or service. Now, this is the hard part, guys. For any target markets, there are usually five or six reasons that if you ask someone to list it, why I buy it. Now, in those five or six, some will have far more importance. Price may be the number one that's consistent across all of these axes. Quality might be the one that's there, depending on the type of product you're buying. Now, I'm using the example for sports shoes, and looking at the literature, what students have said, status is one of the reasons you buy your shoes, it being cool. Image, comfort, price, quality are pretty much, depending on, say, who your target market are, and you could have, for sports shoes, three different age groups looking at the same product. It can vary which is more important. So I'll show you in the example next. This is what I do. Anytime I'm doing a segmentation map, the moment I have a target market, I try to rank according to the literature, what we know. This is where all those mini reports and looking up references comes in handy. What are the most important reasons for someone to buy? So we do, and this is a distinction, the positioning map, the company decides what they think is important. A perceptual map is exactly the same diagram, but with survey data. It's good to know for multiple choice questions. Now, here's just some of the dimensions of what you can do. Lifestyle, leadership, competitive, whatever. I'm more interested in this hands-on exercise now. I'm wearing a pair of Superstars that are here. I was going to buy that until I was informed by my family that that is what young teenage girls and university students buy for Superstars. To say I was offended that you took a product that was in its peak when I was your age and you now wear it as a fashion item, it appalls me. But it's a good example because the reasons I'm buying that versus your reasons are totally different. So let's have a look how this would actually work. Now, we have, when you do a positioning map, guys, if you draw one, which is high quality and high price only, I will fail you in your assignment automatically. You always do three positioning maps, right? High price, high quality is just the starting point for any conversation. Now, what we normally do is we sit there and based, if the target market is here, we're going to say teenagers, well, then we start playing. And you guys might go, well, you know what? Let me drop out of this screen into this screen here, guys, because I can actually move it live. Now, you might go, oh, you know what? Converse goes there. You might go, oh, Vans is a bit better, a bit lower. Or they might actually sit in the same space. Nike, that's just shit, it goes there. Sadly, you guys disagree. Nike might be there. Or we go, oh really? No, when you put Nike there, that's fairer, that works. Oh, Adidas, oh, I don't know, might be there. You might then go, oh gee, ASICS is up here. Then you might go, oh yeah, New Balance is there. But you can see that in, what, less than 5 seconds, because we've used the logos of the company rather than the name, it gives us and it reminds us of the brand. Instantly, we've mapped that. We've gone, hey guys, this is what the reality is for, you know, teenage, it might be teenage males, it might be teenage females. It's that simple to do. Start with anywhere and move them about. Right, now if we turn this to elite athletes, right, you have ASIC there, you might have Nike there, you might have Adidas there, you might have Vans and Converse here, because they're going, well, high price, high quality, but is that really why? So depending on who your target market is, athletes, doesn't that change our starting point? And it rearranges, if we go back to the order of these, and again, depending who your target market is, these all can be rearranged. And that's where, when we go back to our positioning map, it gets interesting. So again, look, if we put very cool, uncool, right, you might find Adidas, Nike, all of a sudden from, depending on how it is and who your target market is. And that's the art, that if you're sticking with one target market, depending on these attributes, it changes. So what do you then advertise on? You realize, well, look, you know what? New Balance is just not cool, right? Adidas thinks it's cooler than Nike. I don't know. They may be the same, they may not. But this is where we play around. Now, let's go to the next one. And again, this would be the same if we did it for athletes. But see, we could change these attributes here and go high status. And this is based on what we're hearing from or getting from our research results. And we might even change it and go, you know what, instead of status, let's go very cool. So not only are they cool, they've got high status, and it's something that people want to get. All right. So again, what's the highest status? It might be ASICS, that could be over there. High status, no. High status, no. Again, Nike, where? Again, guys, we just play with this, and this gives us all of our advantages. Look at this, we're bringing in comfort. All of a sudden, Vans and Converse and ASICS kick ass, right? Or it might be Nike. Again, I'm just showing you that when you change all of these attributes, it makes a fundamental difference to how you do things. And again, I'm happy with you to use bloggers, surveys, reports to do this, or if in your assignment, if you happen to ask a few friends, guys, here's a travel destination, you get five or so people, do it with them. Next week's tutorial task, I'm going to get you to do positioning maps for a couple of product categories that you like. The only way to learn this is to actually do it. And I'm happy if you just copy this template and change the target market, the audience, drop in some logos to save you drawing the axes or what have you. But see here, now the only other thing is, if I love Kotler segmentation variables because it just brings in usage rate, potential user, first time and none. If you can get this up on Google in a PDF, it's well worth looking at. Again, I just got a couple of basic segmentation variables, but I just wanted to remind you, this is the one that doesn't get used. Your usage is very much one of my favorites. That's where the money is coming from, your actual behavioral stuff. Now, how do you choose and implement a positioning strategy? Here are a couple of points and what to avoid. And here's a little summary. But overall, guys, we'll go back. The part that is most critical is being able to pick any brand, any service, and drop it on here. Right, so it could be for tourism, very adventurous, family friendly, scary, exotic, Instagram ready. I don't know what variables you're going to pick on it. All of these things, guys, are just to show you that you need three positioning maps. You change the attributes depending their importance changes on the target market. Can't reinforce that enough. All right, guys, hopefully that helps, but this is the harder marketing.